Hey, what's up guys? In this video, I want to talk about the IMI Defense Level 3 Retention Holster. This product will probably pertain more towards law enforcement personnel, military personnel, the armed guard. This product will not pertain to someone that's, you know, a CCW holder or someone looking for concealed carry systems and stuff like that. Possibly for the responsible armed citizen that wants to open carry in public and that needs this level of retention. So, IMI Defense is an Israeli company. This product came to me from Israel. If for some reason you decide to order directly from IMI Defense, it's going to take at least 3 weeks to get this product in your hands. And that's not because the thing is out of stock or they're making it for you. They actually ship it immediately. But when it hits the United States, it gets stuck in customs. As an example, this one, when it came over here, it got stuck in New York City ISC, which is the United States Postal Service's customs warehouse, I guess, also known as the Black Hole. It was there for 2 weeks. I don't know what it was doing there, but it was sitting there for 2 weeks. When I finally received the package, or it was a large envelope, it was obviously opened and resealed. So they opened it up. They must have wanted to see what was inside and look at it and whatever. All right, so anyways, this is a level 3 retention holster for a... Well, it's not made for a Mark 25, but it's actually made for a 2022, but it fits the Mark 25. You know, I got this because I was interested in getting a holster for this pistol. Do I plan on carrying this pistol? I don't think so, but I always like to have some type of holster, okay, for whatever pistol I own for those just-in-case moments where I may need to carry this out and about for some reason. So that's why, you know, I was interested in this. Now, I guess we could try to compare this with the SERPA holster because it's kind of similar. I do own a SERPA holster, but for the life of me, I can't locate it right now. Honestly, I'm not a fan of the SERPA holster. It's for my Mk25. We could have compared them because they do use a very similar locking system on the trigger guard. And they use the same type of release mechanism, okay, in the same position. Now, what I'm curious about is, does the SERPA holster's release mechanism for the trigger guard, is it lower than this one here? This one seems higher. You know, there's all these fables out there, which, a couple of years ago, there was some individual at a public shooting range who drew from his SERPA holster and had a negligent discharge. He wasn't hurt or anything, but he, you know, shot the concrete floor. I wasn't there, but that's the fable that goes round and round locally. So that's a training issue, guys. It's all about training. But there are some people that feel that the SERPA's design may not be the most intuitive. I don't know. As you can see, this one has a release, you know, around the trigger, but it's aft, up, you know, over it, which I'll show you in a second here. But let's just talk about this holster. This has a paddle attachment on it, as you can see. Alright, that's a paddle attachment. Using the Allen key, you can actually remove this paddle and purchase different accessories. Now let me tell you something. The IMI Defense holsters, I believe they make these for Sig Sauer. If you go to Sig Sauer's website to their SIGTac accessories page, you'll see these on there, and I believe IMI Defense builds these holsters for Sig Sauer, and then they resell them, you know, branded with their name on there. And you can see all the different models. They sell them for HKs, they sell them for Glocks, and, you know, you can go check those out. But they sell all these different attachments for this holster system. They actually call it the RHS, holster system accessories, I guess. And you can see them right here. See, you can have all different, well, that's a magazine carrier, but like stuff like this, you can attach to the back. That's like a belt, probably like a, I don't know, a belt clip adapter maybe, or a belt loop adapter, a mole attachment for a chest rig, which is pretty cool if you're in the military service. Actually, a friend of mine, I was FaceTiming him, showing him this system, because he was curious about it. He's former military, he was over there doing what he had to do, and he said, like, wow, man, he's like, I wish we had systems like this. Back then, it would have been a lot easier, and you know, this thing is much more intuitive, much more natural than what we had to use. But like a mole attachment, there's actually a guy at PM. He's in a special operations group or a SWAT team for a city department, and they started using these systems, and he says they're training with them, and they're very happy with them. So, interesting. Yeah, belt loop, probably. But anyways, you're able to remove this paddle and, you know, start putting different things on there for the certain specific task that you want to use this holster for. You know, I know the Serpa holster is very popular with law enforcement. A lot of plainclothes and detectives use them for their weapons. This might be something, I don't know if they have the, they probably don't have the choice to pick what holsters they're actually issued or authorized, but this might be something interesting to look at. If you're an armored car guard, this definitely might be something you would want to check out, because when I was doing armored car, you know, work, I actually used a Safariland Level 3 holster back in the day, and that thing was somewhat difficult to manipulate because it was a Level 3. And for my Glock Model 22, and you had to do like all these different moves with it, you know, unsnap this behind the trigger guard, unsnap the, you know, the thumb brake, you know, tweak it down, and then you can draw it out. This is much more natural to draw your weapon, but I'm not even sure if people still use those Safariland Level 3s. The model escapes me now, but I don't think so. I think everything is pretty much like this now. But, alright, let's check out what the weapon looks like in this holster, you know? Basically, just insert it in like that. You'll hear an audible click. The trigger is now locked in there. And this hood here snaps down. And you got Level 3 retention. It looks like this. To get this weapon out, all you need to do is basically acquire a grip. This thumb here releases the hood. That one depresses the trigger lock, and it comes out. Remember, on target, on trigger, off target, off trigger. So basically that's how it works. And I think it's a pretty intuitive system, guys. If you know you need something like this, much more natural. I mean, like I said, that Safariland Level 3 that I had to use, it was like a snap down here, a thumb break up here, you got to go like this, and then you gotta rock the gun out at a certain angle to get the freaking thing out. It was crazy. I was practicing on the draw with that thing like every single night, because you could possibly be in a bad situation. You can't freaking even get your gun out. And that's what I mean by concealed carry holders. You don't need all this. You don't need like press this, press that, say the password, enter this, and finally get your freaking gun out. It might be too late. But for people that are in a profession that they need to carry a weapon, you know, this might be an option, like executive protection. I know some guys that do that, and they use Level 3 retention holsters, even though they're concealed under a suit. They still use Level 3. I just want to show you this. This is at a neutral cant. So, again, this is more like a duty holster. At the end of the video, I'll show you what it looks like on me. But, again, this is like, see how this, I mean, you're not going to conceal something like this. But I have to say it's much more intuitive, just because you can, you know, acquire a grip like this, and you can draw your weapon. I don't know, guys. Tell me what you think. Again, this is to serve a role of a specific market. So I'd be curious what you think about it. All right, let's just check it out, what it looks like on me. Here we go. All right, as you can see, I got the holster on right now, just to kind of show it to you, how it comes out, how you draw. And as you can see, this is not a concealed carry holster. If you want to look at it closer, definitely a duty style holster, as you can see. So Level 3 retention requires you to release the hood, draw it out, okay? But that's what it basically looks like, guys. So, leave some comments, and as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.